Rock 105.7 plays Kingston's Rock.
It's Sideshow. I'm outside the Tragically Hip's Bathouse Studios just outside of Kingston, Ontario right now. The Headstones are inside as we speak, working on their new album, Little Army. Hugh Dillon's going to give us a tour, so let's go take a look around.
What are you doing? Stupid. Come on in. He's actually recording, so come in. But... Keyboard player, road manager, Trent's brother. Trent, the guitar player in the Headstones.
Hello.
Chris, who's producing Little Army. Niles, who's fixed everything so we don't look like talentless fools. Sam, who works here and babysits us. Some guitars, guitar room. So you can do all sorts of tracking here. This place is, you can, what we've got, our setup is all Trent's amps. That piano we used on a couple of tracks. We've used everything in the studio at one point or another for this record. With every amp, every guitar, every possible setup, and of course the Phantom power board. It just gives the whole place such a killer atmosphere. Yeah, this is just a great room to track in. Flash library. This is all backup vocals. And you're here. I've used this room for other projects, but for this one, for Little Army, we did, I'll show you. This room's been great. And the darkness at the bottom has forgotten what's on track. The storm has never ceased here, and it'll never stop. Well, I'm a red meat eater, liar, and a cheater, and I shook the hand of God. I met him at my dealer's. What's the deal with the killing? Did a lot of vocals on this record right here. The setup was great, and if you can see up here, there's microphones that catch the vocal when we're standing here doing backups. But this was our engineer Niles. He has recorded some great stuff. He's done a lot of work with Broken Social Scene and the Hip, and he's just got great kind of old school ideas that really work for us. And this was spectacular. The sound is different. It's a different sounding record.
Out here on the ocean, adrift upon the sea.
Foosball.
I'm staring at the stars now.
The lake.
But what's become of me?
Canadian winter.
Can't even move a muscle. I can't even think. The water's all around me, and I just want to drink.
Done a little bit of recording up here. There's all, you know, we've got everything. And what's great is, about recording here for an extended period of time, you don't just have to get in and out. So it's not, yeah, no, that's great, let's go. We experiment more than we have on any other record. And so all of a sudden you find, you know, like we use that Hammond B3, we use sounds that we've always wanted to do, but you just don't have time. And this has been like just a really smart way to record. It was like how we did Picture of Health. We had the time, we've got great equipment, we found the right vibe. Everybody gets along and it's exciting and fun. It's not a job. It's like, it's really creating something that you're gonna wanna live with. And every time you hear the tracks, you like it as opposed to, yeah, it's good, we gotta go. You know, it's rock, it's great. Yeah, and it's just, and you know, Kingston's home and this is the hip's place. So just everybody feels comfortable and you just want to make a record that you can live with, and we've been able to do that, and we've got a couple of days left to mix it down, and it's just the vibe. You can see just by being here, it's like it's not sterile, you know. Everybody has fun, everybody can express their opinions as opposed to, okay, let's go. It's just been great. And even just people stopping by, and just the whole vibe of this place. The Day for Night artwork, shot of me in one of my first movies. Just don't stay too long on that, Sideshow. Just, you know, they have like to put up various shots of my early stuff. I remember when I was a kid in Kingston, Easy Rider, when I saw it, the drive-in, it was my favorite movie. And then I used to go to the Queens. Oh, I forget where they, but the Queens would put on movies when I went to KC, and you could go and drink beer and smoke cigarettes in the theater, and Easy Rider was playing. I loved it because I loved the soundtrack and loved the music. And then years later, I did some bad horror movie and Peter Fonda was in it. I was like, that's Peter Fonda.
Nice.
Easy Rider. It's great. Every morning we come down to go to work, get some coffee, greeted by the fully, completely artwork, which makes us know we're in the right place, which is pretty spectacular.
I smile because I know I tried firing up the circuits. Can't see myself jumping double dutch, you know, I smell the plastic burning. Last night was a pessimistic skydive in a foolish narcotic shell. Beat the bottom out of frames of lightning.
You know, you're welcome anytime, Sideshow, but your wife, I don't know. One day I try on my little bolero, see if that's gonna fly. She goes, that's ridiculous.